Hello everyone, in this video we will teach you how to animate the buttons in easiest way. Don't forget, why forget? Save it us. I've been dreaming on in my head like I've seen it. A
life worth living is a life with meaning. To get us started, create a background first. To separate buttons layer from background, make a copy with Ctrl D and add a UI button. Resize button as you wish. For a sprite, create a 2D circle. You have two choices to change the sprite. The first is to use pre-made image, the second is to select the sprite from within Unity. Let's try second way. For this, drag the circle you made to source image section. Now you will see the button is not like a button, it's oval and isn't beautiful. To change it, do this. In the image section, change the simple image type to a sliced. It has a warning that says the image doesn't have a border. To set border for the image, click on image and change sprite mode to single. Then bring up a sprite editor and click apply. In a sprite editor, you can specify borders for image. Place all borders in the center of circle. Press apply and click on the button again. Drag circle toward image, and if image type wasn't sliced, change it to a sliced. Look at the button now, you will see cool curves in the corners. To manage these curves, change the number of pixels per frame multiple. If you increase the number, the curvature of the corners will decrease. And if you decrease the number, the curvature increases. In color section, you can change the button's color. For changing button's text, there is a text object in the button's child that you can edit it with several options. Sometimes you have pre-made image and want to change its shape or something else inside Unity. For this, set border for the image like you did before, then drag it towards source image. Here you can change the color as you want. Now if you change, oh shit, here we go again, pixels per multiplier. Now if you change this f***ing number, the button's image will change very nicely. It looks better if you change your button text. I will. Let's get to what we made this video for, animating a button. For this, click on the button and in the button component, change color tint to animation. For creating animation, we have two ways. The first way is to create the animation manually in the old way from animation window, which we do not do. The second way is to click the auto generate animation in the button component and specify the place to save the animation. If you look at that animation, you will see five animations are here to the names you see here in the button components. Normal is for when the button is in its default state. Highlighted is for when the pointer passes over the button. Pressed is for when you hold or press the button. Selected is for when you release the button. Disabled is for when you uncheck the interact table checkbox in the button component that we don't use it in this video. As you see in common state, the normal animation plays. When pointer passes over it, highlighted plays. Unclick, pressed animation plays, and after release, selected plays. After clicking somewhere else, normal animation will play again. Now it got too easy, only you need to record any animations that you want from this list. For example, when mouse passes over button, the button gets a little bigger. For this, highlighted animation must be recorded. Click on the button and choose highlighted from this list. If you don't know anything about animation, animator, and basic animation in Unity, I suggest you to watch above video. Press record and choose a frame like 20, and increase button's scale a little. After play, when your mouse passes over the button or a stay on it, button will get bigger. But this animation plays again and again. Why? Because the loop box tick of animation is not removed. So uncheck loop time box of all animations. Now again, if you play and pass over the button with mouse, the button gets bigger and highlighted animation plays. Now what if in addition to what you did, you want to play an animation by clicking the button? For this, record pressed animation. Go to highlighted animation and get a copy from last frame and paste it at the first frame of pressed animation. Why? Because highlighted animation will play it first, then pressed animation will play. Then press record and continue what you recorded in pressed animation. In addition to scaling, you can give it various options. For example, change the color of the text. For this, select text and change the color as you see. Normal mode don't need any animations and it is default state of the button unless you want it have animation. After play, if your mouse passes over the button, highlighted animation will play. After click on it, press animation will play, and when you release the button, selected animation will play. If you click somewhere else, normal animation will play again. In order to better understand, let's delete this button and try another button, light settings. I want this button to have an opening form, so I add some image in its child. Got a taste, can't erase bitterness in my face. Work a job every day till your dreams fade away. Like a card, never change. Play the game that we say. Well, this is the overview of settings. Normal animation of this button should be just compact. When mouse passes over it or unclick, this menu opens. So, for first animation, pull up this menu from below and make its child transparent. Click on the button and in the button component, change color tint to animation. Click the auto generate animation in the button component and specify the place to save the animation. In highlighted mode, I want that this menu gets open. So I press record button and drag down the menu and give color to its child. Now if your mouse passes over the button, you will see the menu opens, but it never stops, cause it is in the loop and loop box never got checked. After play, you will see when your pointer passes over the button and a stay on it, menu opens. Now let's add some pressed animation to the button, like the highlighted animation. So, cut all frames of highlighted and paste it in pressed. Now if you click on the button, you will see menu opens, but it closes right after opening. Why? Cause after clicking, selected animation plays. So copy last frame and paste it in the first frame of selected. It's done. Now if you click on the button, its menu gets open and you can click on its child. And if you click somewhere else, menu closes.
I hope this tutorial was useful for you. Don't forget to like and subscribe us. Thank you.